Our sixth presenter is Poonam Choudhary from the Department of Medicine. And the title of her presentation is Advanced Imaging for Pre-Symptomatic Diagnosis of Krabbe Disease. Not only is she an expert in medical sciences, but she also has an interest in fashion design and can speak, read, and write three languages fluently, which is quite impressive. So, you ready? Set, pitch.
Good afternoon, everybody. Let me start with an assumption that if you are from Buffalo and an avid football follower, you might have heard of Krabbe disease. Have you? Well, if you haven't, let me inform you about it. Krabbe is a rare neurological disorder which becomes fatal within 2 to 5 years of life. And being genetic in nature, it is currently impossible to predict and prevent it from happening. Now, if you ask me about the two most important factors in treating a disease, my answer would be the accuracy of the diagnosis and its timely treatment. Shown on the left-hand side is the newborn screening, a process of testing blood samples for newborns for Krabbe disease. But there are some issues with this process. For one, there's 25% chance of detecting false positives or false negatives, meaning Krabbe disease can either go undetected or it can be falsely diagnosed. Second, not being a federally mandated procedure, it is only applicable in just few states, and New York is actually one of them. So when a child gets diagnosed or misdiagnosed with Krabbe, that child has to go through an excruciating stem cell therapy, which comes with heavy side effects. Nobody likes to be treated for what they don't have, especially infants. The physical and emotional toll on the child and the parents is just unimaginable. My research shows that by using advanced imaging technology of PET and MRI, it is indeed possible to detect pre-symptomatic biomarkers of Krabbe disease in 15-day-old mice. And by the word pre-symptomatic, I mean the time before the physical and clinical symptoms appear, which is a very crucial period to nip the disease in the bud. In future, we will translate this animal study in humans. And if we are successful, then we will be in a better position to recommend advanced imaging along with newborn screening across all medical centers in the country. To conclude, for those of you who are still wondering about the connection between football and Krabbe I mentioned in the beginning, for them, my suggestion is to go home and do some research about it. And here's a hint. The Buffalo Bills quarterback who took Buffalo to Super Bowl 4 years in a row. Thank you.